Sony Computer Entertainment America presents a Universal Interactive Studios production.
A game created and developed by Naughty Dog.
Hey everybody, I'm Flamin' Flares. Welcome to Let's Play Crash Bandicoot Warped. Alright, let's start up a new game. And we got a cutscene. Once again, starting right away after the second game. Just like in the second game where it started right away after the first game. What is this? The Cortex Vortex is falling, and BAM! Into a temple. Okay, I'll shut up for the rest of the cutscene.
At last. Uka Uka is free. No, it cannot be. Evil, great evil has come. Even once, but you, Cortex, you have failed me twice!
Great Uka Uka, it was that infernal bandicoot!
From deep inside my temple prison, I sent you simple instructions to follow, but you lost the gems, you lost the crystals, and I have lost my patience! There is now no other power source left on this planet.
I know. We've had a few unfortunate setbacks.
And failed. But since your bumbling has managed to set me free, I am feeling generous. There is still a way for us to amass the power needed to enslave this miserable planet. And this time the great Uka Uka will make sure that you do it right.
After many eons, my evil twin, Uka Uka, has been freed from his underground prison. Long ago, I locked him there to protect the world from his malice. Now, free once again, he must be stopped. Children, Uka Uka and Cortex plan to use this time-twisting machine to gather crystals that lay scattered across time. I have brought you here to recover the crystals before they do so. To open the time portal, simply stand on a button and then jump into the portal. Good luck.
Right, so, here we are. And my controls are screwed up, so I'll just have to use my D-pad. Anyway, once again, we are back in the Crash Bandicoot world. Here's our first level. Toad Village. That's right, we're going into the Mario world.
Crash, crash, crash. Why must you always muck in my mud? Oh, look, I have a mask helping me, too. We will find out which one is more powerful soon enough.
Ooh, we will find out which one is more powerful soon enough. Whoa. But yeah, we're in Toad Village here. I have to get used to my Xbox controller again, because I've been playing a lot of PS2. Because, I happened to find, all the Jack games, except for the second one. Okay? So I've got the first one, you know, Jack and Daxter, the Precursor Legacy. I've got Jack 3, and I have Jack X Combat Racing. Okay. I found all of them for $10 at Walmart. But I can't for the life of me find Jack 2. But I have been playing Jack 2 a lot. Because, my uncle let me borrow that. Yeah. But, yeah, we're in Toad Village, and, doing our Crash Bandicoot thing here. You know? Our spinning and our jumping and our sliding, you know, And we're in Toad Village. You know, we made it to the Mushroom Kingdom. See? There's the castle up there. Okay, sorry for the Mario reference. But, you know, I'm LPing Paper Mario right now, which, this is actually going to be my LP for until I can get back to Paper Mario. And start also until I can start up Pokemon Crystal. I'm hoping that I can get those two, well, get Paper Mario back on track soon, and get Crystal started going. It's just that I have to replay through Paper Mario, and I'm getting incredibly bored doing it. And Pokemon Crystal, just graphical work, I'm still working on, and buddies are still working on. You know, just trying to get graphical work going. I'm doing a majority of it, but I'm getting major help with it too. So, yeah, that's about it. Let's just get through this level. There's our crystal. Just like the second game, you collect crystals and gems after you get all the boxes, like in the other two games. There really isn't much for me to explain because I've explained it all in the previous two LPs, well, of this series anyway. I'm getting slowed down, aren't I? I don't like getting slowed down, but, yeah. The new thing about this is that, we go through these portals, and we have this whole warp room. We can actually see the entire warp room all at once, which I think is cool. And, you might see that, relic there. Yes, that is a time relic. That's the new thing in this game. I will be covering all the time relics all at once at the end of the LP. That's all I'm going to say about those. But as I was saying, you can see every single section of the warp room, and no matter how hard you try to skip through the game, it's not going to let you. Funny thing is that I think in Spyro 2 they use this sound effect. Just take a listen to it. Sounds like a sound effect they use in Spyro 2. Although this game came out before Spyro 2, so, you know. And, yeah, we can take on Under Pressure. Just, you know, really quick. This is a nice short level, too. You know, the first five levels are basically just to get you back in the mood of Crash Bandicoot. But this is a swimming level, and the mechanics for this are actually really decent compared to Mario swimming levels. This is like God. Okay? That is all I'm going to... Shit. All I'm going to say about it. Basically, you know, your D-pad just moves you around, obviously. You press X to swim faster, and square and circle, just like in the first game, square and circle allow you to spin. And then, of course, triangle does what it normally does. Oh yeah, that's another new thing for this game, is that if you press triangle and look at your box count, it shows you how many boxes are in the entire level. Now I gotta admit, that is really helpful, because though it was helpful that they gave you a count of how many boxes you had in the second game, it wasn't helpful because you didn't, unless you were like a nerd, and knew how many boxes there were in the entire level. Or you looked them up on Google. Which, back when this game came out, Google was, not the great thing we know today. It was, you know, just starting up, sort of, I think. You know, the internet was pretty much just starting to go boom. And not everybody had a computer, you know. Not everybody had Facebook like they do now. Well, Facebook wasn't even a thought. Okay, so this thing has its own controls. Now, X allows you to fire these things. So does Square. Circle makes you, like, dash forward. And, of course, triangle does nothing unusual. Triangle's just your HUD button. And, if I would stop getting slowdown, I mean, jeez. I mean, I know I'm recording, but I don't need to get this much slowdown. I really wish I could be playing this on my PS2. I just don't have, a copy of the game. Nonetheless, do I have a memory card, and crap, I screwed myself over. I am going to purposely kill myself now. Okay. because once you lose that thing and you don't hit all these coral reef things, well, there's boxes inside these coral reef things, and you don't get the boxes, you know, no gem, and you lose that thingy, no gem for you. So let's try this again. That's why I don't like really dashing in the crap here. I'm nervous about that. Let's see if I can do this right. I just like to spam square or X. Depends on what button mood I'm in. You know, depends on what button my thumb is on. If I can hit the damn box, I'd be happy. This is really hard to do with the Xbox 360 D-pad. If you guys haven't played with a 360 controller, the D-pad, it's like this, it's like another analog stick, basically. And it's really, it's just a lot more difficult than an analog stick, though. I mean, I would rather have my, I kind of wish I had a Logitech, gamepad thing. I almost died there because I touched this thingy. Don't you love how descriptive I am with all my stuff? Okay, let's get this thing and get these. All these thingies and that thingy and, all this crap. Okay, do that, and that. Shit! Okay, I'm fricked. I'm fricked! Yeah, well, we were right there by the end of the level, so, yeah. Not that big of a deal. Let's just, see, if I was actually using... if my controls weren't screwed up, because someone was messing with them, apparently, and it wasn't me, I would be using my analog stick, and I would just be zooming through this level. Yeah, hopefully in the next part I actually remember to, slow down. Jeez! Okay, stop skipping frames. Thank you. Okay, hopefully in the next episode, or the next... Really? Really? Did I really just do that again? The next time we go into one of these water levels, I will hopefully remember to change my settings by then. Because honestly, this just sucks. Yeah, you don't want to be touched by those shocky things. Which makes no sense. But this is just video game logic. Electricity and water doesn't hurt you. And jeez, I killed the eel and I got a lot of slowdown. Okay, it really doesn't like this part of the game, I guess. And this is just the first part. So if we're getting this much slowdown in the first part of this Let's Play, I can just imagine how the rest of it is. Just do all this stuff again. I swear, if I have to die again, I'm just gonna cut until I can get past... I got past the shark. Son of a biscuit! Okay, cutting. I am cutting to that part. Shit. What? I pressed down! Not left, down! Let's slowly... Whoa, pufferfish. Die! Okay, well, we can just get that out of the way. Just get all these, get the crystal, and move along. Move along. Okay, we got the gem. That is amazing. Alright. We are done with the level. That was a lot more failed than it needed to be. I hate this stupid trackpad. But anyway, we finished two levels in this part. So I think that's all we're going to do this part. So, next time on Let's Play Crash Bandicoot 3, Warped, almost said Cortex Strikes Back for whatever stupid reason, we're going to head into the level... I forgot, the controls are screwed up there. I tried to use my control stick again. We're going to head into this one, which actually Coco gets to play in this level, so we'll check that out next time. Peace out.